Look at the force in space in this example. The angle between the force and the y-axis given, and it is denoted as theta sub y. Using this information, we can easily find the y component of the force using the angle theta. It's equal to the magnitude of the force times the cosine angle. The y component of this force is shown using the dotted line on the x-axis in this diagram. However, we don't know the other two angles between the force and the axis x and z, but we do know one more angle, which is on the xz plane. Finding the xz component of the force is a two-step process. First, we find the projection of the force on the xz plane using the sine value of the angle theta. Let's call this component of this force as F sub xz, and its magnitude is shown here. This is actually an intermediate value. Once we know this component, we can easily determine the x and z component of the force using the angle phi as shown here. As you can see, this is an effective approach if you know two angles. Various problems may have slightly different information available, but you should be able to determine the components once you have a good understanding of what is given. In case of our flower pot, for simplicity, let's say the angle between the vertical line and each row is the same, and it is theta sub y. The angle between the projection of the force F1 on xz plane is phi. With this information, you can easily find the x and z component of the force just as we did before.